Hello and welcome to this assembly for Monday the 8th of March 2021. The last couple of weeks I've spoken to you about perseverance and patience, and today I'm going to speak to you about something that makes both of those things possible, and that's hope. As Alexander Pope put it, hope springs eternal in the human breast. Hope sustains us. We can't keep going if there's nothing to hope for. In fact, you could say that we need hope to survive. Hope can be present even when things are at their bleakest and can help us find our way through difficulties. But hope has got to be much more than just wishful thinking. It needs to be grounded and based on something beyond our current circumstances. And as we'll see, it's far from being passive, it needs to be active. And yet we also have to acknowledge that for some people, it's hard to find reason to hope. Last year has been a difficult one for so many. And even though many of us might have got through with no more than a mild feeling of irritation from time to time, it's important to realise that many have felt a sense of hopelessness and even despair, and have struggled to get by. Every couple of months, I write a report for governors and tell them what's been going on in school. One of the things I always do is to look back at the previous year's report and see what was going on then. One of the things that struck me as I wrote the report for this March was that this time 12 months ago, there was so much to include, so many activities going on in school, and it had been a particularly busy and successful time in school sport. But there was also a sense of foreboding as we started to realise that this thing called coronavirus was going to be a real problem. Things were starting to shut down, but even then we couldn't have imagined just how things would change. The idea that schools would shut for 12 weeks or that exams would be cancelled would have seemed outrageous, yet now it's happened twice. So this year's report was very different. There wasn't so much to include for a start. But if there was a sense of impending doom this time last year, we now have reason to be hopeful that we can emerge from this pandemic and start to get back to normal, or perhaps even something better than normal. The amazing work on vaccines has provided a way out, and recent announcements about the easing of restrictions have opened up the possibility that a brighter future is not too far away, or to use a well-worn phrase, that there's light at the end of the tunnel. What makes you feel hopeful? I love all of the seasons. Most years I go away during the winter over the February half term and enjoy some winter mountaineering in Scotland. I wasn't able to go this year for obvious reasons, but generally when I come back, I feel ready to put the winter behind me and really look forward to the spring. I think it's hard not to feel hopeful at this time of year as the air starts to get warmer, the days begin to stretch. When you go out early in the morning, you can hear the birds singing, and here in the school grounds, everything starts to come back to life. The snowdrops come out, the daffodils and crocuses bloom, and the trees start to come to leaf. And we can be hopeful now that we can start soon doing some of the things that we used to enjoy. Meeting up with people again, coming back to school, getting involved in all of the activities that I mentioned earlier, going to events, visiting places and enjoying being out and about. We've only got to wait a little bit longer and then a lot more becomes possible. There's the promise of regeneration, which I think is even better than getting back to normal. It's about renewal or being restored to a better state. If we can emerge from this pandemic with a fresh sense of gratitude and a willingness to learn from our experiences, then I do think that we have reasons to be hopeful. And one more thing, finding hope for ourselves is one thing, but we can also bring hope to others by getting alongside them, saying an encouraging word, giving a helping hand, and showing kindness. So almost 1 year on, let's find reasons to be hopeful and look for opportunities to bring hope to others. Let's look forward to a period of regeneration. That's something to be thankful for. Well, thank you once again for joining us for this week's assembly. We're really looking forward to having pupils in years 12 to 14 back in school on the 22nd of March. And as you know, we've extended term by 3 days, so you'll have a bit longer in school before the Easter holiday. I'm sorry that we won't be having the rest of you back then, but we do very much hope that you'll be back with us after the break. Keep up your good work from home and try to get involved in some of the other activities that have been posted out to you. Miss Cochrane will be taking next week's assembly, so please join us again next Monday. That's all from me for today, but I'm going to leave you with some music. String players Jasmine Buchanan, William Wrong, Ruth Potter, Alice Martin, Zoe Belshaw and Beth Cairns are playing A Romance by Kember with Mrs. Blakeman on the piano. Enjoy that and have a good week.